The earliest Homo sapiens have been present and spreading in Africa for about 200 to 300,000 years. While the exact location of the first Homo sapiens in Africa is a topic of ongoing debate, scientists are certain that Homo sapiens originated in Africa. The reason why humans began to migrate across the African continent 200,000 years ago and why some groups migrated from the continent 100,000 years ago remains unclear. Scientists have hypothesized that resource scarcity, potentially caused by a major ecological event such as a prolonged drought, may have been a driving factor behind these migrations. Africa, in the last 200,000 years, has experienced many different climate changes leading to colder and more arid conditions, and then to warmer, moister conditions where the Sahara is completely covered with vegetation. 70,000 years ago, the continent cooled, causing dry, arid conditions. Early humans may have been forced to venture beyond their familiar habitats in search of food or other resources. Homo sapiens was the species best equipped for this type of migration, thanks to their ingenuity, tool-making skills, and language. While there were early migrations of Homo sapiens out of Africa prior to 70,000 years ago, they wouldn't have shared the same mtDNA as present-day humans. Mitochondrial Eve is a hypothetical woman who lived in Africa roughly 170,000 years ago, and all individuals alive today can trace their maternal lineage back to her without any breaks. By analyzing DNA from indigenous populations residing in South Africa, scientists were able to determine the probable time and location of our most recent common maternal ancestor. This is possible because mtDNA is solely inherited from one's mother, leading to its transmission from one generation to the next. We'll start with her for the migration of the ancestors of modern man. Homo sapiens migrated from East Africa to Eurasia and became the ancestors of modern humans who eventually settled outside of Africa. Equipped with tools, fire, and language, Homo sapiens were equipped to successfully migrate to remote parts of the world. Fire served multiple purposes such as providing warmth, deterring predators, and cooking meals. Tools proved to be crucial in hunting and gathering food, as well as constructing canoes and rafts for travel. Language played a vital role in coordinating their efforts for hunting, sharing knowledge, and navigating across seas into new continents. With the increased size of hominoid brains, early humans gained the capability to communicate with one another, resulting in the formation of intricate social structures. Without communication, it would have been impossible for a group of 15 individuals to collaborate effectively in building a raft to sail to Australia or navigate along the coast of the Americas. Around 70,000 years ago, our ancestors exited Africa, journeying through the Arabian Peninsula and then onto the Indian subcontinent. Initially, they traveled along the coastal regions of Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, and Burma, ultimately arriving in Australia via rafts. The initial phase of the migration involved traveling east to India before venturing south towards Australia. The settlements found in Australia are proof of an ocean voyage 50,000 years ago, and it's a remarkable feat for early humans. The motivations and conditions surrounding the initial voyage, spanning at least 50 miles across the ocean, remains a subject of speculation. Did they start this journey deliberately, starting new lands for subsistence and shelter? Or did they encounter monsoon winds that brought them there? The boats Aborigines used in ancient times that we know about were unsuitable for lengthy journey. The most plausible suggestion is the use of bamboo rafts. Ocean levels 50,000 years ago were about 300 feet lower than they are today. This lowered sea levels expanded the landmass of Asia, extending it as far as Java, and caused the northern coastline of Australia to be closer to Asia. Despite these changes, significant sea gaps remained between islands. These gaps necessitated the use of seafaring boats to navigate and complete the journey. But why did Homo sapiens not travel west to Europe during this period? While earlier attempts were made, they proved unsuccessful. Homo Neanderthals had already inhabited Europe for over 200,000 years before, and they thrived there with adequate food and living conditions. One possible reason for the absence of a successful migration could be the competition between Homo sapiens and Homo Neanderthals for resources. With the Neanderthals prevailing and forcing Homo sapiens to migrate eastward as their only viable path for survival. We will discuss later how Homo sapiens ultimately succeeded in inhabiting Europe. Homo sapiens began migrating to southern China approximately 45,000 years ago, following the grazing herds. However, migration into northern Europe was delayed until the icy glaciers receded. Migration was also happening into Korea and Japan around 35,000 years ago. Once again, the sea levels were about 300 feet lower 35,000 years ago, allowing migration into Japan, Taiwan, and the Korean Peninsula without the need for seafaring boats. China's coastline expanded to Taiwan, and the Korea Peninsula coastline almost expanded to Japan. The second major migration occurred 50,000 years ago, as Homo sapiens migrated westward from the Indian subcontinent through the Middle East and Turkey, and then into Europe 45,000 years ago. Unlike their previous attempts, this time Homo sapiens were successful in their migration despite the presence of Neanderthals. The reason for this success is not entirely clear, although evidence suggests that Homo sapiens in Europe interbred with Neanderthals. Today, non-African humans have about 1 to 2% of Neanderthal DNA. It is uncertain whether interbreeding was the reason for Homo sapiens' success, or whether they were simply better at fighting and surviving diseases. Regardless, Homo sapiens thrived in Europe while the Neanderthals went extinct. The third major migration involved a northern expansion into Russia. Since the ice sheets in Eurasia were only present in the northwest area, this left East Asia open for human migration to the Americas. About 25,000 years ago, our human ancestors crossed the Bering Strait, either via land bridge 25 to 16,000 years ago, exposed by sea levels 425 feet lower than today, and migrating through an ice-free corridor, or by hugging the coast in boats and migrating down the western coast of Canada and the United States about 16,000 years ago. They continued south through Central America and reached the bottom of South America 14,000 years ago. The rapid speed of migration from Canada to Argentina in 2,000 years was likely due to the Homo sapiens' experience with boats on the sea. Approximately 12,000 years ago, as Homo sapiens were migrating across the Americas, other groups of Homo sapiens were also on the move in northern regions of Europe and Asia. These individuals were pursuing herds of animals that were moving in response to the retreat of glaciers. Homo sapiens' remarkable ability to adapt and innovate through the use of tools, fire, and language allowed them to overcome challenges and migrate to all parts of the world. Resource scarcity, ingenuity, and complex social groups all played a role in this extraordinary journey. Our human ancestors' legacies live on today as we continue to explore and push the limits of what is possible. Please subscribe and like for more content like this.